I mean, Chris has devoted his career to stopping black people and poor people from voting. I mean, that's been your goal for decades.
That is an outrageous accusation.
Well, it's completely true.
Absolutely outrageous accusation.
I mean,
if you like photo ID, you're trying to stop people of color from voting?
Absolutely.
That is outrageous.
Absolutely.
And by the way, when this question is polled, the vast majority of African Americans approve of photo ID. So apparently they're trying to do what you're saying I'm trying to do. That is outrageous.
It is such a horrible accusation. It is a completely true accusation because, Chris, I mean, your whole career has, I mean, that's why you had this phony voter suppression commission that was such a preposterous joke established by the president that it disbanded because it couldn't prove your claim that voter fraud is a problem in this country. Your problem is that some people vote for Democrats, and you want to stop that by establishing voter requirements. Look,
I love that Toobin didn't let up, because normally what happens is a Republican does fall outraged, like, oh, how could you? I am shocked and chagrined to find out that you think I'm doing voter suppression. Chris, every astute observer of politics knows you're doing voter suppression. You're the leading advocate of voter suppression in the country. That's why Trump put you on that commission. I'm going to get to that commission in a second because the results of that was hilarious, and Toobin is 100% right. So now let me give you a sense of voter fraud numbers in the country. There's been a great number of studies on it. This one's from the Washington Post, actually. Brennan Center for Justice reported on it. A comprehensive 2014 study published in the Washington Post found 31 credible instances of impersonation fraud from 2000 to 2014. Oh, wow, there's 31 cases. Okay, is that real? Out of more than 1 billion ballots cast, even this tiny number is likely inflated, as the study's author counted not just prosecutions or convictions, but any and all credible claims.
In regards to impeachment, I'm curious, Patrick. Nancy Pelosi tells me that you guys are looking forward to it. So do you want us to impeach Donald Trump? Say it right here on national TV.
I think Nancy Pelosi, if she wasn't as smart as she is, should be goaded into letting her caucus lead her down that rabbit hole of impeachment.
So do you want it? Do you think Donald Trump should be impeached?
Donald Trump would love that, and here's the thing.
Okay, but would you love it? Do you think Donald Trump should be impeached?
Is going to do well with that when you try and sell it to the mainstream of America.
I am going to sell it.
There's nobody out there who gets this except you. You're going to try and do it.
Do you, but you're Patrick.
Do you want Donald Trump impeached?
Because I hear from the Democratic leadership that you want Donald Trump impeached. Is that true? Do you want him impeached?
I think the Democrats should try to make their entire campaign about impeaching Donald Trump.
Okay, great.
And
then you want it.
Okay, as they did with Hillary Clinton.
Oh, Patrick Griffin. Looks like you want to get Donald Trump impeached.
Cuomo was having fun there too, watching that. He was like, okay.
Tucker Carlson was confronted by an American truth teller while he was at a fly fishing store in Montana. Now, this American truth teller wanted to call him out for his vaccine disinformation. So let's take down the lower third, take a look at the video. And it is a little difficult to make out what they're saying, but there are some subtitles to help you out.
I don't care, man. Okay, just dude, you are the worst human being known to mankind. I want you to donate to this thing, to the United States, to everything else in this world. I don't care that you're not here. What you have done to people's families, what you have done to everybody else in this system,
So there you have it, someone approaching Tucker Carlson in the flesh and confronting him about what he does on his show nightly, which is air all sorts of divisive commentary, disinformation, which means intentionally lying to the American people about the vaccine, which has certainly led to some vaccine hesitancy in this country, and it's been a disaster. And what's amazing about all of this is the kind of backlash the man in the video has gotten from right wingers, which I'll get to in just a second. But let's talk about who this guy is. His name is Dan Bailey. Again, this is in Montana. And when he posted this video on his Instagram page, he included a caption that said the following. It's not every day you get to tell someone they are the worst person in the world and really mean it. What an a-hole. This man has killed more people with vaccine misinformation. He has supported extreme racism. He is a fascist and does more to rip this country apart than anyone that calls themselves an American. And so he's proud of what he did. And to be quite honest with you, it is cathartic to watch someone like Tucker Carlson, who has no problem directing hatred, anger, harassment toward what he perceives as his political opponents, for profit, by the way, get called out on his behavior. And the people who are crying about this are the same people who tend to be the so-called free speech warriors. People like Dinesh D'Souza, who whine about protests toward right-wing speakers on college campuses, but then turn around and argue, I'm not even kidding you, that Bailey should be arrested. Let's look at his tweet. This is a shocking video. This man should be arrested for what he did to Tucker Carlson in front of his daughter.
He hurt Tucker's feelings. The man's gotta be arrested.
I mean, free speech for me, but not for thee.
Right.
Which pretty much defines the right wing.